so that it's less likely that we get shown up by talking birds in the future, we've set up a little bit of exercise for solving systems of equations with substitution. And so this is the first exercise, or the first problem they give us. -3x - 4y = -2, y = 2x - 5. So let me get out my little scratch pad, and let me rewrite the problem. So this is -3x - 4y = -2. And then they tell us y = 2x - 5. So what's neat about this is that they've already solved the second equation. They've already made it explicitly solved for y, which makes it very easy to substitute for. We could take this constraint, the constraint on y in terms of x, and substitute it for y in this first blue equation, and then solve for x. So let's try it out. So this first blue equation would then become -3x - 4, but instead of putting a y there, the second constraint tells us that y needs to be equal to 2x - 5. So it's 4 times 2x - 5, and all of that is going to be equal to -2. So now we get just one equation with one unknown, and now we just have to solve for x. So let's see if we can do that. So it is -3x, and then this part right over here, we have a -4. We'll be careful right over here. We have a -4 that we want to distribute. We're going to multiply -4 times 2x, which is -8x, and then -4 times -5 is +20, and that's going to equal -2. And now we can combine all of the x terms. So -3x - 8x, that's going to be -11x. -11x, and then we have +20. +20 = -2. Now to solve for x, we'll subtract 20 from both sides to get rid of the 20 on the left-hand side. Subtract 20 from both sides. On the left-hand side, we're just left with the -11x. -11x. And then on the right-hand side, we are left with -22. -22. Now we can divide both sides by -11. -11. And we are left with x is equal to 22 divided by 11 is 2. And the negatives cancel out. X is equal to 2. And so we're not quite done yet. We've done, I guess you could say, the hard part. We've solved for x. But now we have to solve for y. And we could take this x value into either one of these equations and solve for y. But this second one has already explicitly solved for y. So let's use that one. So it says y is equal to 2 times, instead of x, we now know that the x value that where these two are intersect, you could view it that way, is going to be equal to 2. So 2 times 2 - 5. Let's figure out the corresponding y value. -5. And so you get y is equal to, and that's where the home stretch, y is equal to 2 times 2 is 4 - 5. So y is equal to -1. And you can verify that it'll work in this top equation. If y is equal to -1 and x is equal to 2, this top equation becomes -3 times 2, which is -6, -4 times -1, which would be +4. And -6 + 4 is indeed equal to -2. So it satisfies both of these equations. And now we can type it in to verify that we got it right, although we know that we did. So x is equal to 2, y is equal to -1. So let's type it in. X is equal to 2, and y is equal to -1. Excellent. Now we're much less likely to be embarrassed by talking birds.